Hi everyone, and welcome to another tutorial. My name is Ryan Boyle, and today I'm going to walk you through using both positive and negative lights to create a sharp noir looking lighting effect in Cinema 4D. Now normally when you light a scene in your 3D application, they are set to a positive value, but with negative lights, they contain a negative value that actually removes light from your scene. To get started, we'll go ahead and create a default light, and you'll notice it's set to 100% by default. If we were to increase this value to, let's say, a higher number like 800%, you'll notice that it becomes very intense and starts to blow out our scene. So what we can do is we can actually create another light and apply a negative value to it that will actually remove the light from the scene, but also sculpt out our character's edges and use negative light to bring back some of the edges. Now, you can also create additional lights, positive and both negative, to bring back some of the edges and parts that are missing in our character. For example, maybe we need a backlight to bring out some of the shoulder area, or maybe we need another frontal light to bring back some of the edges on the arm that are missing. So you'll notice that we still have some gray values in our render. The goal of this is to basically light the scene using only black and white values. So what we need to do is increase the intensity of the lights to, we can say, 1200 or maybe 1400%. And the higher we go, the more intense the lights are and the sharper the contrast the scene will get. Of course, when you're done, you'll have a nice sharp lighting that resembles a comic book or maybe a noir looking scene. You'll also notice that our scene renders pretty quickly since we're not using any special render settings or plugins. Now, if you don't want the background to be black, you can also create a sky element, and let's go ahead and add a white texture or maybe even a grayish texture that will really help pop out the character depending on the look you're going for. And there you go. Well, that about covers it for this tutorial. Make sure you also read up on positive and negative space and design. This will give you some further tips about using these concepts in your future renders to kind of really help make them pop. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Thank you for watching and happy lighting.